Good day, folks. My name is Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. I'm here today to tell you a little bit about my 2003 Lance 1121 camper that I just took in on trade. Beautiful, beautiful camper, all the nice features. You know, with us folks at the RV Corral, we go through everything here to guarantee that everything is in good working condition when we sell it. This 1121 is 11.5 feet long, so it is really designed for a one ton. The people that owned it had a one ton dually, as you can see here with the swing away front power jacks. We get around to those jacks when we go around to the back end. So we do have a slide out. They did have the tie downs that went from here down to the hood of the truck, just to stop that bobbing up and down in the front of the cab area. I do have the sliding rear window to get through from the cab. Little things on the outside here. By the way, the people had a torque lift system, which is pretty much needed with this heavier camper. Storage goes underneath my booth on this side and over here. I have two awnings. One is the main awning on the slide outside over here. The other awning is going to be on the back end. Two propane bottles laying down, very accessible, very easy to get to. They both have sight gauges on them. And in the back end here, we have a ladder to get up onto the roof. Why do we need that? We have an emergency outlet in the front over the bed. If for some reason this door should get jammed, I can climb up through my emergency exit, walk on the aluminum roof up there, and come down to the outside of the ladder. If you notice over on this side here, I do have a built-in generator. That's a 3600 LP generator. Nice step that flips down. When you're traveling, this just flips up. I hope you can hear this. We're right by the Highway 99 right now. So here I have my power jacks, and on the inside I have a control for it, a remote, to where if I want to sit in the bed of my truck and raise or lower the camper, I can easily do that from the inside of the cab of my truck. It works to about 20, 25 feet away. Curtis, if you can come around this side, a couple of things I'd like to show them is, number one, I've got heated and enclosed holding tanks. So for you hunters that want to go over to cold weather, no problem, as long as you've got your furnace running. And then here I have my outside shower, which is always very nice, very convenient. Now, because this is a camper with a slide out, I'm going to have my cameraman, Curtis, go in. I'll open the door for him. One thing I will ask you to do, folks, while you're watching this video, and that is grab a pen and a piece of paper handy, because at the end of the video, it's going to give you my name, my cell phone, my 800 number, so you can write it down. Booth is slid out right now. I do have a double door refrigerator, which is really nice. Got the separate freezer. The Queen Island bed is north-south, so they call that an extended bed. And then there's my exit, emergency exit, you can see right above the bed. I also have a satellite dish on top of this unit, along with a storage pod. AM/FM stereo CD player. I have a nice little pantry off to one side over here with a pull-out. Couple of drawers. Forced air furnace. I have roof air conditioning up above. And this is what we refer to as a dry bath. So I can take a shower without my sink and my stool getting wet. I have a fantastic fan in the bathroom area, which is really nice for dry camping. And then I also have one in the hallway here. A lot of people dry camp right up here. So here's my double door closet right here. Cedar lined on the bottom. And here's my remote control that I was referring to as far as with my power jacks. So in this short presentation, I hope I've given you enough information for you to want to pick up the phone and call me. My name is Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Thanks for taking the time for watching this video. Have a great day, and give me a call.